The city of Vancouver has issued development permits to 14 marijuana-related businesses, and this is part of the city's ongoing attempt to license and regulate the retail marijuana trade in Vancouver. So 62 of the rejected businesses have filed appeals, and those appeals are going to be heard starting this week by Vancouver's Board of Variance, and they're scheduled to go on for the next several months. Here to talk to us about this is David Brown, a Vancouver-based journalist with the website liftcannabis.ca. So, David, can you tell us a little bit about this appeals process and what's going on?
My understanding of the appeals process is several dispensaries who are unable to meet the zoning requirements due to proximity to other dispensaries, schools, etc., will have the opportunity to appeal that ruling.
And what do you think is going to happen?
Well, in the big picture, I think that we will see quite a few closures of dispensaries. I think, you know, we only have 14 dispensaries who have made it to the third stage of the application process. That's 14 out of 176. Even with some variance board approvals, that still leaves the vast majority of dispensaries who probably won't be licensed, in which case we will see different efforts from the city to close them in different ways, I think.
So what steps will the city take to close those dispensaries if they are unsuccessful with their application?
My understanding is the city has 2 to 3 different steps. They can enforce bylaw fines. I believe it's up to $250 a day for not having a marijuana-related business license. They can also issue other related licensing fines. The other option is they could go to the courts and they could issue a fine of up to $10,000 for each business, and they could order a court injunction that would, my understanding, is could be applied to all unlicensed dispensaries, which would essentially close them. My understanding is that the city can then just come in and padlock any unlicensed business, so you aren't running into the optics of a police action with police coming in and actually making arrests. It's just a simple bylaw infraction and they come in and lock your doors.
And we've recently seen the police take actions in some other parts of the province outside of Vancouver, is that right?
Correct, yeah. We recently in Nanaimo, there were some very high profile busts, and other places in Canada, quite a few in BC. And I think that Vancouver is doing their best to avoid that. I think that that becomes a very, becomes a PR issue when you have dispensary operators, potentially even patients being arrested. If the city takes more of a municipal bylaw approach, then it's a lot easier for them to frame it as simply a city licensing issue.
If some of these dispensaries are forced to close down, do you anticipate there could be some messiness or a bit of a fight?
Yes, absolutely. And I think, you will see some pushback from dispensaries who don't get a license. But I think that in the past, the public has shown support when, if the RCMP comes in and arrests people, oftentimes that creates a PR issue that people don't necessarily agree with. But I think that the city's approach shows that they're trying to regulate those who want to play by the rules. And so I think it will be very challenging for those who, for whatever reason, weren't able to make it through the process. It'll be difficult for them to claim that this is still a civil rights issue when, some are being licensed and some aren't.
And finally, how does the federal government's commitment to legalizing and regulating marijuana, how does that play into all of this?
That's an interesting question. Trudeau, when he visited Vancouver a few weeks back, mentioned that the federal government is looking to coordinate with provinces and municipalities in terms of those regulations. So I think cities like Vancouver, who are setting out to at least license the retail sale of cannabis, it's important to remember that they are not at all licensing the supply. The supply chain, they aren't licensing how it's grown, how it's produced, how it's packaged. They're only licensing the businesses. So I think that we could see municipalities like Vancouver, Victoria, possibly Toronto, starting to look at how that integrates into the federal recreational legalization plan, but we're probably still quite a ways away from that.
Great. Thank you for joining us, David.
Thank you, Dan.